It's a great honor to be here at the inaugural of Fikki Frames, and of course, to be interviewing Aamir Khan. And Aamir, first, happy birthday and fabulous at 50.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Aamir, when you're here at this conference, and do you look back at, you've been now 3 decades in the industry as a young man who came in his mid-20s, this first film. When you look at how far the industry has come, when you are presented with KPMG reports, when you're talking about bottom line and how far this industry can go, what's your perspective on this?
You know, I have to say, I've never read the KPMG report, I'm afraid. I should, I know I should. But
also, I hope none of them are sitting here.
No, I mean, that's the truth. I should. It's really, you know, it's not good that I don't read stuff that is, you know, related to my work. But the problem is that I get too lost in what I'm doing. And so when, you know, people talk about the business side of films or the media industry, I'm quite lost. You know, I have no idea how to increase the business. I often, yeah, I really don't. Because I get lost in stories, and that's what interests me. So I think pretty much in these last 25, 27 years that I've been working, it's just been my excitement towards the films that I'm doing. I do feel, however, you know, I was listening to everyone speak, and it kind of sparked a lot of thoughts in my head. And we talk of economic growth for our country, and we all, I think everyone in this room has a dream, you know, for what we want our country to be. All of us really have a dream in our hearts to see our country, you know, where maybe our forefathers wanted it to be. And I feel that, you know, especially during the research of SMJ, when I went through so many things, I learned a lot, and me and my team, we often discuss about this, you know, we feel that, how do we achieve that dream? How do we, you know, one of the observations that we have is that Indians, by and large, are, you know, they take to hardware very quickly. Latest phones, we have it, you know, latest computers, we have it. But the software is where I think the issue lies, is because we are the software. You know, as a country, we believe that in for economic growth, we have to have infrastructure and bridges or, you know, whatever. Various infrastructure, highways. You know, we can build highways, we can build bridges, we can build dams, we can build all of that. But ultimately, we have to use it as human beings, we have to use it. And that is where I feel the crux of the matter is. For example, when I leave my house and I'm at Linking Road and I'm at a traffic jam, or rather, there's evening, you know, traffic, invariably somebody will go from the right of me and try and go from the other side of the traffic. And then that causes a traffic jam, which then you're blocked for, like, you know, whatever, 4 or 5 hours. Now that is us. So somehow, if we really want to achieve the dream that we all have in our hearts, I think somewhere we need to look at the software of India. Instead of the hardware, we need to look at the software of India. How are we as people? And if that is where we can bring about a change, that is where the big change lies, is where I feel, you know.
Just taking off from that point, because if you look at the software then of the film industry, television, communications, how do you involve, say, a spot boy as much as you'd involve an Aamir Khan or a Kamal Hassan in looking at the stakes involved in pushing this as an industry, professionalizing
Actually,
it?
Pushing as an industry, I'm meaning it in a different way. I don't mean it in that way. I don't mean it in making more films or making more money out of the films or making the industry
more productive, perhaps.
That many more crores, bigger. That's not how I'm looking at it. Because I feel that the opportunity is much larger than that. Mm-hmm. The opportunity that we have in front of us is much larger than that. For many years now, I've been feeling that what is our role as creative people or the people who are in the business of entertainment? What is our role? You know, whether you're on television or film, or you're a writer, painter, dancer, whatever you are as a creative person, what is your contribution to society? Sure, it is to entertain. Of course, that's our primary job, is to entertain people. But I don't know whether that stops there, or rather, I don't know whether it should stop there. I think one of the responsibilities that we could choose to shoulder is that we can bring about a dynamic change in society. That opportunity is there in front of us. It's up to us whether we want to take it or not. We can bring grace to society. We can build the social fabric of India. We can contribute to nation building in a very, very dynamic way. In what we choose to tell our children, in our stories, in our characters. I mean, if you look at the content coming out of our work for children's content, it's almost negligible. And the little that I see is very scary. The little that I see is that my son watches sometimes, you know. I sit with him and it kind of scares me to see the kind of children's content we're making.